Hello, everybody on Facebook, YouTube. Welcome back. This is Chris. I am here for the Institution of None and All, and we are discussing the evolution of religion today. We're really discussing evolution in general and the evolution of human beings, the evolution of culture, the evolution of consciousness, but the evolution of humans, the evolution of all of those things are tied together, actually. Maybe some people don't care to see it that way, but that only continues to further reduce your part in it, and your ability to change any of this only further, you know, disempowering you to make any difference in the world and in the way things are. So I would say choose not to see it that way. Let's start with evolution. When we talk about evolution, we're working with phylogenous matrices, which is kind of a fancy way of saying webs. They're like chains of molecules. You have little discrete bodies or fields of things that happen, that matter, and that get counted for. And then when those have solidified into proper items of history or of concept or of action, fact, that we can analyze and identify, we have to attach them to other things that they're related to. We don't ever view them in isolation. They have to be viewed in their comprehensive complexity, and that's the only way to properly understand evolution or science. So we need to create complex chains, these webs, these representations that show us how things work, because that is how they work, and that's the nature of nature, that's the nature of reality, that's the nature of the universe, and we know that now, and that's why we're so good at the science that we're good at, because we have arrived at a pretty sophisticated understanding of reality and nature that does more or less reflect what actually is. The problem is for science, that's an admission of defeat. They're only now catching up to where mystical spirituality has been all along. In the beginning, before men were men, they were animists, you know. Men and women, human beings, had critical relationships with the environment, with the land, with the animals on the land, with the plants on the land, and anywhere in the world where you went, human beings were defined by the habitat which they lived in. So the variations that you see in culture, the variations that you see in religion, the variations that you see in language, the variations that you see in all of these things, none of this was created for any purpose. So you can throw all your conspiracy theories about religion just being this tool to control people. It never was, and it still isn't, if you don't let it. And no animistic person would, because an animistic person would view their relationship with the universe as a sacred, critical thing. And no matter how crazy things got, they would always look inside and use their own internal compass to work. You're all shaman. Some of us are better at it than others. That's true. And so if you see a shaman who's more powerful than you, maybe you would like to ask them to intercede on your behalf. Maybe, if you'd like, and we do. Okay, but the spirit of evolution, the spirit of religion, the consciousness behind all of this stuff, that's driven by individuals who are deeply, deeply, deeply connected and invested in the universal condition. The church is not important. The church is how you should feed yourselves, it's how you should organize yourselves, and it's how you do. All of you have a problem with the institution. It doesn't matter which institution it is. You can call it the Catholic Church, you can call it the U.S. government. You can call it the university that you work for or go to. You can call it the job and the boss that you hate and you can't stand but you're attached to. But every time you get into a system, it could be your father and your family. It may not be what you envisioned. It may not be what you hoped for when you came down here. and you were born. You know, but the split between whether or not the institution that you're stuck in successfully fulfills you or does not fulfill you isn't a question of the institution at all. It's a question of the people inside the institution, and then at the first step it becomes a question of yourself. Are you going to take the mystical path, or are you going to take the institutional path? Are you going to take the way of the do not, or are you going to take the way of the being? If you take the way of the being, you will start with the greatest good, and you will work towards collectivism, and you will arrive at the inherent problems of collectivism after you've attempted collectivism. If you start with the church and the structure, you will arrive at the horrors and the inherent problems before you come to the collectivism, and therefore you won't like it, and it won't be good. So you have to start with the mystical. You have to keep it on the real side, the side of the spirit. Those of you who hate religion, you hate the church. But you can't hate yourself.